Hello, I hope you're doing well. Welcome to a very special Let's Talk dedicated to all the Star Wars fans out there, and hopefully that includes you. If not, well, hopefully you'll find this enjoyable or relaxing, regardless. As you can see, I thought I would have a little fun with this video. I picked up this hat and this shirt just for the occasion. I am a fan, of course, but I would say more along a casual fan. I do know a lot of the characters and things like that, but I'm not a diehard where I would get dressed up in cosplay and go to a convention or anything like that, which I think is great. I would love to, but that's just not something I've ever done, actually, no matter what the theme might be. But so I thought we'd have a nice little relaxing chat about the films, some of the scenes, talk a little about each film. This isn't really going to be analysis or anything like that too much, but we'll see where it goes. Now, before we get any further, I do have a little questionnaire, a little quiz, just to test your knowledge about the Star Wars films. And then we'll get into some other questions about your likes and dislikes about the films, stuff like that. Okay, so question number one. What planet did Luke Skywalker grow up on? That would be Tatooine. If you recall, that's where Obi-Wan found Luke. That was with the Jawas and the land speeder. And that's when that's the very first New Hope episode of the very original trilogy. And Tatooine is also where the Jabba the Hutt palace is located. I think it's also the cantina as well. Okay, question two. What is the name of the weapon that a Jedi or Sith uses? It's a pretty easy one. That would be a lightsaber, of course. Question three. What was the name of Han Solo's ship? Millennium Falcon. I'm keeping these fairly simple, just in case there's, you know, casual folks out there who maybe haven't watched the films in a long time. Number four, which Jedi lived on the planet called Dagobah? That was a lot of forest and swamps on that planet. And that would be Yoda. If you recall, that's the first. Again, it was New Hope. It was actually episode 4, but the first of the original trilogy from the 70s, when Luke takes an X-Wing and travels to Dagobah, and that's where he finds Yoda in his little hut, and Yoda's going through Luke's backpack. Number 5. In Return of the Jedi, who was Princess Leia slave to? That would be Jabba the Hutt. I'm sure he doesn't need much of an explanation. Question 6. What is the name of the powers that the Jedi and Sith use? That would be the Force. something that Obi-Wan Kenobi, you remember, he was an older Jedi in the first Star Wars, when he lets Darth Vader strike him down, and I think he was the one that says, the Force flows through all life and living creatures and things like that. I believe he said that. Number 7. In episode 1, The Phantom Menace, which is the first episode of the second trilogy, who is Qui-Gon Jinn mortally wounded by? And if you recall, Qui-Gon Jinn was training a younger Obi-Wan Kenobi, and they got in a fight with someone who eventually hurt, pretty much almost killed Qui-Gon Jinn. The guy had red and black face paint makeup, and he had the double sided, the dual lightsaber. It'd be Darth Maul. Number 8. What was the name of the new droid in The Force Awakens? He's got that round body and kind of like moves around, almost like a gyroscope. His head floats on top of his body a little bit, and he's got like orange and gray coloring. That would be BB-8. That would be the Force Awakens, the 7th official film in the franchise. Question 9. What is Boba Fett's profession? That would be bounty hunter. And last question, who is Luke Skywalker's father? Of course, that would be Darth Vader. Hopefully you know that one. All right, so why don't we get into talking about all the films, just real quick. I did this mostly just to add a little character to the video, but these are pretty much the extent of the toys that we own. We purchased these about, I don't know, 6 or 7 years ago, I think. These aren't any of the original toys from way back in the 70s. I did used to own, I think I had the trash compactor, I think I had a toy Millennium Falcon, and a couple others. So I was into action figures back then, He-Man, G.I. Joe, so I'm not sure if you have any of these. Over there, that's the that's Princess Leia hanging down, and that's that I forget the heck its name, but it's the creature that from Empire Strikes Back that captures Luke on the ice planet Hoth, and that blue ship is a TIE interceptor. It's like a TIE fighter, but it's called an interceptor because its wings is supposed to be faster, I think. And then we have here, we have the from Rogue One. This was the Asian type, or Asian character, but Asian type character who was blind. And I believe he was a Jedi, but he didn't have a lightsaber. Or he wasn't, I don't really quite know for sure. And that is Greedo. And I think we may have a couple other action figures. All right, enough of that. So let me ask you, which film is your favorite? And I want to get into talking about all of them, including Rogue One as well, even though it's not really an official Star Wars film. But which film is your favorite? Would it be one of the original three, A New Hope, episode 4. Episode 5, Empire Strikes Back. Episode 6, Return of the Jedi. Would it be one of the three from the second trilogy, which is episode 1, Phantom Menace. Episode 2, Attack of the Clones. Episode 3, Revenge of the Sith. Is the newest Star Wars within the, I guess, the newest trilogy that I think is supposed to happen, starting with Kylo Ren and Rey and Finn in The Force Awakens? Or would Rogue One be your favorite, which is kind of like my new favorite now? So what, love to hear which one is your favorite in the comments. If you like, and I also want to ask you two other things. Which character is your favorite? Darth Vader, Luke Skywalker, Princess Leia, Rey, maybe one of the characters from Rogue One, maybe Yoda, Boba Fett, Han Solo. Last question. What is your most memorable or favorite moment or scene from any of the movies? Would it be young Anakin and the pod races from Phantom Menace? Would it be Yoda fighting Count Dooku, I think it was, in The Attack of the Clones? Or was that Revenge of the Sith? I forget. I think it was Revenge of the Sith, wasn't it? When Yoda was, I think that's when Yoda was, we saw him fight for the first time. Was it the big reveal from The Empire Strikes Back when we find out that Darth Vader is Luke's father? Would it be The Force Awakens and when we find out what happens to Han Solo and Kylo Ren? So I'd love to hear your answers for those three questions. But besides that, I would share a little bit of my experience and how I get started, I guess, being a fan, and share some thoughts and moments as well. So I saw the original trilogy, episode 4, 5, and 6, as a child of the 70s, and I'll never forget being blown away when we found out that Darth Vader was Luke's father. I mean, at the time, those movies were just, movies back then just seemed to be more captivating. I don't know what it's like to be a child today with the movies we have out now. It seemed like the movies back then were more magical, but maybe that's just me because now I'm grown up and desensitized or oversensitized to all the types of movies and graphics these days. But you know, that was all the computer animation and all that didn't really exist too much back then. It was all a lot of, you know, puppeteering and, you know, Jim Henson's Muppets, that kind of stuff. So, that would be one of my, you know, most memorable moments, and I'm sure it is for a lot of folks. And I also have to ask, did you see Star Wars in which order did you see the films in? Was it the original three from the 70s, or did you see the second trilogy when you see young Anakin grow up and learn that he became Darth Vader? See, I saw, of course, growing up, I saw the original trilogy and finding out that Darth Vader was Luke's father during the movie was just a big, you know, mind blower, and I wonder what it's like for anyone that didn't see those first, but watched the second series of the second trilogy, and saw young Anakin, and that, so that might have, I would think that might kind of take away from the big surprise of finding out that Darth is Luke's father, because you already knew that from the second trilogy. So I was, and there's a lot of folks that don't like the second trilogy too much. Let's talk about some of the, I guess, pros and cons of the films. In terms of, I don't want to analyze the plot and plot holes and things like that. So I'll tell you that one thing I didn't like about Return of the Jedi was the Ewoks. I think at the time I was okay with them, but I think when I got a little more older, I started to think it was like too childish. I liked the maturity of Empire Strikes Back. I liked Return of the Jedi for Luke and fighting his father and fighting the Sith Lord, which Emperor Palpatine, that part of it. Of course, it was Endor, and the speeder bikes, and not the AT-ATs, but the smaller ones that were on Endor. Those were introduced. That was kind of cool. At least I don't remember seeing those in Empire Strikes Back. That's the only thing I didn't like too much about Return of the Jedi. The very first Star Wars, New Hope, that was a lot of fun. The trash compactor scene, I thought that was great. There's a lot of memorable moments that are a little mix of comedy, lighthearted comedy as well in there. The cantina, you had the Jawas, you had those sand people, the Tuskens, I think that's what they were called. You had the big fight scene with Obi-Wan Vader. So I liked the first original trilogy from the 70s, I think 80s as well, I forget exactly when they all came out. But like I said, I think that my only gripe really is the Ewoks, and the kind of, I thought Empire Strikes Back was kind of more the darker, serious of the of those three. And then Return of the Jedi had its moments, but it seemed to be a little bit more, I don't know. It has its moments for me. Love to hear what you think, of course, of any of the films, what you like, what you don't like, which episode, and things like that. So I love Empire Strikes Back. I thought that was great. It started off kind of a little dark, somewhat. I mean, you had Luke going out and gets caught by that Hoth creature. You can see I'm not a hardcore fan. Han rescues him, cuts open the Tauntaun. See, I remember that. Shoves Luke in there. You have the AT-ATs and I forget the name of the ships, speeders, with the tow cables, they wrap around the AT-AT and bring it down. That was cool. Seeing those, marching across the frozen wastes of Hoth was pretty great. Then you had, you know, you had Luke fighting Darth Vader, finding out the big reveal. Luke getting his hand cut off. What else was there with Empire? And then you had Han Solo getting frozen in carbonite. So it was a, it took a little bit of a darker turn with the characters. And it seemed to be the more mature of the three that I think. So, but and then you had, of course, Jabba the Hutt was Return of the Jedi, right? That's right, because Han Solo was frozen in carbonite. And I actually owned, I've always thought about getting into voice acting, doing voiceovers, and something I think about. I had an album, and there was someone that did the Return of the Jedi, and they did the, like, it was a spoken format. And I used to listen to that, and I used to mimic the person that was narrating Return of the Jedi on the album. I owned that, but that was great. Return of the Jedi with Jabba the Hutt, with the Rancor, the Beast. You had the, when they were out on the floating space thingy, the skiff or whatever the heck it was, getting ready to get fed to that creature in the pit, the Sarlacc, with all its teeth. And that's when Boba Fett, you know, gets shot and killed and falls in. So that was the great rescue. And then the whole thing on Endor and all that, and blowing up the second Death Star. And of course that was great with the first original Star Wars, was blowing up the Death Star, that whole sequence of the TIE fighters trying to get in down through that, I can't describe it, not tunnel. But when they had to fly down through the Death Star and drop their, shoot their torpedoes, or I think that's what it was, and to try to blow it up. And that's when Darth Vader and a couple other stormtrooper pilots came down to fight, try to destroy the TIE fighters and the rebels from doing that. And that's when Darth Vader, his ship gets shot, I think, and he goes spinning off, and that's the last you see of him until Empire Strikes Back. So love the original three. Of course, like I said, I was a kid then. And then when you grow up, you know, things kind of change, and you kind of lose that childhood innocence a little bit. You know, you just, you know, you just grow up a little. And that's when Phantom, that's when the second trilogy came out. And we didn't see those in the theater. I forget when exactly they came out. My wife and I'm not sure if we were married at the time. We didn't have our son yet. I think the third one came out before the birth of our son. I forget. Can't remember at all now, but I think we, I'm not sure if we saw one of them in the theaters. I can't recall. I don't think so, but definitely remember watching them at home, you know, renting them or like through Netflix or something like that. And I thought the second trilogy was good. Of course, I don't think as good as the original three. With Phantom Menace, you had young Anakin, that you had Qui-Gon Jinn, and I forget his name, but he was training young Obi-Wan. And I should know their real life actors' names. I just, for the moment, they're off the not in my mind. you had them him training, and Qui-Gon Jinn was kind of a maverick. And then they end up fighting Darth Maul. That was probably one of the better moments of The Phantom Menace. You had that long pod race thing, which I didn't like it. It didn't seem to fit. I mean, it was okay, but it just seemed too long. I didn't care for young Anakin, the actor, you know, too much. So that, it was okay, that one. Nothing too memorable, you know, for me at least. Maybe you have a different, you know, feelings and memories of that one, which is, you know, just fine. And then there's the second one, which is the Attack of the Clones. And that was with Jar Jar Binks, and I think there's a lot of folks, me included, that didn't really like that character. I can appreciate the character for its comic relief, but and its animation and all that, but I don't think it belonged. I think it was just, you know, I think it was kind of bad. I don't think a lot of people out there are on the same page with that. But Attack of the Clones, that was fairly good. It was Jar Jar Binks in the Attack of the Clones, right? I don't think it was the Phantom Menace. Anyway, whatever one Jar Jar Binks was in, I can't remember the Attack of the Clones too much. I think that's when Obi-Wan goes to investigate the clone army, if I'm not mistaken. That one was kind of lackluster a little bit. I think the best of those three is Revenge of the Sith, because that's when things get a little darker, more mature a little bit, at least. At least for my taste and my liking. You know, your mileage may vary. That's the big fight between Samuel Jackson, who was a Jedi, and Emperor Palpatine, and Anakin decides not to help Samuel Jackson's character, who I forget, and so you can probably remind me on that, and any of you more diehard fans out there might correct me on a lot of things, but and then you had the fight between Obi-Wan and Anakin, when Anakin really just turns to the dark side and becomes Emperor Palpatine's apprentice. And you also have, in that one, I think that's when Anakin also, isn't that where he learns about his mother's being held captive by, his mother being held captive by the Tusken Raiders, the Sand People? And he slaughters all of them. And if I'm not mistaken, I don't think it was the Clone Wars. I think it was the Revenge of the Sith. But, so I would have to say Revenge of the Sith, for me, at least, was the best of the second trilogy. And again, I would love to hear what your thoughts are on that, on the first three episodes, 1, 2, and 3 of that trilogy. I think also, like I mentioned in the very beginning, I think seeing Yoda flip around and being the Jedi, the younger Jedi that he was just awesome. You know, he was like a little flea, just hopping around fighting, I think Dooku or Emperor Palpatine, I forget. So that was great. Seeing that, fight between Anakin and Obi-Wan. The Darth Maul scene was okay. It was cool. You know, he was an interesting character, but the Phantom Menace and Attack of the Clones, they were just kind of lackluster, I think. Trying to remember what other famous moments there might be. Let's move on to the seventh installment of the episodes or the series, and that would be The Force Awakens with Kylo Ren, the newest Sith in training, I guess you would say, apprentice to this Supreme Leader. And they don't really give much background on who the Supreme Leader is, so I can only guess that they might explain that at some point. I don't know. So we saw that in the theater. Of course, now our son is older and not a teenager yet or anything, but so we saw it in the theater and thought it was good. Didn't like Kylo Ren, at least the character, the actor that played. Nothing personal against the actor. I saw that actor, I forget his name, in a movie called Midnight Special, which is fantastic if you haven't seen that. So I like him as an actor, but I didn't like how he acted or portrayed Kylo Ren. It just seemed like reminds me, I guess, of myself or a lot of us when we were teens. Somewhat mopey, a little angsty. Maybe that's how he was supposed to be portrayed. I don't know, but I was, for the way that Kylo Ren was portrayed with his helmet on and everything, then when he takes it off, I don't know, there's just something something seemed off. But I'm analyzing a little bit, aren't I? I said I wasn't going to. I loved The Force Awakens for the fact that Ren, the girl, was the lead actress, I should say. But I think that was great. I love to see that because there are a lot of white males. Again, nothing political, but it's just how it is in many movies. So it's great to see a different take and someone else to be a lead, you know. Besides always typical guy, you know, being the hero, you know. So that was great. And apparently she's a Jedi. And I'm not sure. I thought she was left on that planet. I forget the planet that she was on now. But wasn't she abandoned there or something? She put there, I forget now exactly what happened, her background story. Then we have Finn, the stormtrooper that defects and joins the rebels. But though he was kind of really just looking to not even be involved, he was kind of in it for his own gain. I guess he just wanted to get out of being a stormtrooper, didn't want anything to do with being a rebel either. I think at one point, but then he turned and ended up helping, coming around. So The Force Awakens was okay. Again, maybe it's because I'm turning into a bitter old man. I don't think it was as good as any of the, well, I think it might have been better than maybe like The Phantom Menace or Attack of the Clones, but I just didn't feel it. I felt it was okay, Star Wars film. You know, there wasn't a lot of interesting things in that, like with the first, like with other movies. I mean, like, you know, you had the AT-ATs and you had you had the cantina, you had Boba Fett, but there wasn't much of that in The Force Awakens, you know, that I recall. I mean, there was that one little cantina-like area where Han Solo and Rey and Finn went to meet a friend of Han's, and they find Luke's old lightsaber. So there was that. I mean, there was the area, there was the planet that Rey lived on, and that little marketplace. But it just didn't, I don't know, maybe it's just me, It just didn't seem to have that magic, you know, of like the other Star Wars films. And maybe that's because of J.J. Abrams. It was J.J. Abrams, right? I haven't seen too many of his other films. I saw that 10 Cloverfield Lane. I'm not sure if that was by him. But I haven't seen Cloverfield or... I think he did the Transformers films as well. I'm not much of a fan of those. So The Force Awakens, our son liked it a lot. So again, you know, different perspective. You know, I'm older, getting older and all that. And I did enjoy some of it, especially the scene with Han Solo and Kylo. Of course, I was kind of expecting that. There was so much hype about what was going to happen in that film. I kind of felt that something was going to take place there, unlike the original Star Wars films. Now, I would love to know, it'd be kind of interesting, if Empire Strikes Back was released in today's world, with all the social media and everything like that, would we know about Darth Vader being revealed as Luke's son? And, you know, would we have that kind of expectation, or that kind of foresight, however you want to put it? Of course, there would be a lot of leaks, and I'm sure, and spoilers in today's world. But when, back then in the 70s, you didn't have the internet. And when a movie, I mean, there wasn't, you know, spoilers or anything like that, really. When a movie came out, I mean, the only reason you might hear of a spoiler is if someone, if you didn't see the movie and you heard someone talking about it in class or whatever. So it'd be interesting in today's world. But for the most part, you know, most if you avoid, you know, news sources and certain sources, you know, you can pretty much not have anything spoiled for you. But still, it was hard to avoid a lot of the hype with The Force Awakens and a lot of the talk in the air about Han Solo, you know, and, you know, what's going on between Han Solo. It was hard to avoid the titles of articles and things out there about, you know, what's happening between Han Solo and Kylo Ren. So that was a good addition to the Star Wars franchise. I mean, it reopens it up. And on a quest to find Luke, of course, Rey ends up on the island or wherever that Luke is at. And hopefully, knock on wood, we don't lose Mark Hamill before the next episode is released. And rest in peace, Carrie Fisher as well. Had her loss at the end of 2016.
Again,
I'd like to hear your thoughts about The Force Awakens. And, I mean, it was good to see, you know, Han Solo and Chewbacca back. I mean, that was cool. And see Rey steal the Millennium Falcon on that planet, which I can't remember the name of it for the life of me. So there were some good memorable moments from that one. But overall, it was a okay. It was a good film in the franchise, but I just didn't think it was as good as, you know, the original trilogy, any of the original trilogy from the 70s. But again, maybe that's me. And then we have Rogue One, which is not an official Star Wars film. I forget exactly who produced it. I looked into it a little bit, but I forget offhand. I was kind of curious. I loved Rogue One. I thought where I am now, and my interests today, and my, you know, my likes and dislikes, I thought Rogue One and my tastes, you know, how my tastes have changed, where they are now. I thought Rogue One was the best Star Wars film ever, even though it's not an official Star Wars film. Now, Empire Strikes Back has always been my favorite. And then Return of the Jedi. But I'd have to say Rogue One is right up there with Empire, if not ahead of it. I love the maturity of it. I know there's a lot of... I saw some critics just before I was hitting record on this video. I was looking on, up some information. And I saw some critics say that, you know, Rogue One was kind of generic, a generic story, and there's no character development and stuff like that. And when it comes to movies, I like to be a simple person. Maybe I am a simple person. But I like to enjoy the movie for what it is, you know, especially because I'm paying for it. I don't want to, you know, go in there and have expectations. But I love Rogue One. And I loved the ending. I loved the premise was great. I love some of the special effects with the Star Destroyers. Star Destroyers up in the atmosphere above the planet, which I can't remember the planet's name, where the show, the movie ended. It's a little sad at the end with, you know, things that happen to certain or all of the characters without giving anything away, in case anyone didn't see it. But I loved, I mean, there was lightsaber battles that were missing, but I loved Rogue One, and I can't place it. Maybe it was the, I want to say maturity of that film. You know, there's no Ewoks, there was no Jar Jar Binks, there was no, like, kind of childish aspects to it. So I can't really point my finger on what it is about Rogue One, but I loved it. And I would love to see more films that delve into some of the background, like, how did Yoda come to be a Jedi? How did Obi-Wan become a apprentice under Qui-Gon Jinn? You know, we already have some background on Boba Fett. How did Han Solo become I don't even know what the heck his profession. I loved Rogue One, and it doesn't have the magic of the, you know, Empire Strikes Back or Return of the Jedi, and it's probably blasphemous for me to say that Rogue One is better than Empire or Return, but I was just, I loved it. I was kind of not blown away, but I left the movie, like, really impressed by it, you know. So maybe I'm still a kid at heart, you know, I probably am. I don't ever want to grow up. It's a trap, anyway. But, so I'd love to hear what you think about Rogue One as well. I loved all the characters. I can't remember any of their names. I liked the one character who was Asian, sort of Asian at least. He was blind, and I think he was a Jedi, but he didn't have a sword, or he was just very... He thought he could use the Force, but he was just very well adept at hearing and things like that, so I don't know. Of course, seeing Darth Vader in that, and some of the things that he did with the Force towards the end of the movie was great. So there was a, I liked the film and how it played out. Like I said, I'm a simple guy. I like my films for what they are for the most part. I try not to nitpick them and analyze them, you know. But of course, it's not my job. I'm not a paid critic. So maybe if I was paid to be a critic, I probably would say more things, more critical. I think that's really it. I just wanted to have this little chat and have this, dedicate this to kind of go down memory lane a little bit, and talk about some of the favorite things from the different films. You know, I liked all the different characters. Of course, I think I like Luke as much as I like Darth Vader. I also like Yoda. I like all the different characters. I'm not really sure growing up who I liked more. This is what I love about art. Even though, you know, there may be plot holes and there may be bad acting and things like that, that's what I love about art, whether it's a Star Wars film, whether it's an independent film, whether it's a cartoon, or it's a painting. You know, it's someone's idea and they're expressing it, and it moves us and it leaves a lasting impression on us. And it's great stuff. Don't know where we would be or what we would do without art and film. It'd probably be a very boring and depressing world, just having houses and trees and I don't know what else we would do with our lives. But you know, it's a great escape too, I guess, from the often banality or monotony, and how often sometimes our lives are mundane, you know. So I hope I did all you Star Wars fans and justice with this video. I do want to do a Star Wars roleplay video, in case you're still listening, haven't fallen asleep or anything. I know I did a lighthearted one with Yoda, but I want to do one with a more serious one, like I'm a Jedi Master or something like that. I haven't figured out quite yet how I want to do that, but we'll see. Thanks for tuning in. I hope you enjoyed. And again, love to hear anything you have to say about the films. And I guess that's really it. Until next time, take care of yourself. I wish you all my best as you travel down your own path in life. Take care of yourself, and may the Force be with you. Nanu nanu, or live long and prosper.